Now you've done every exercise to bow smoothly. And if you're looking at your wrist and fingers, you're making all the right movements. But you still don't have the sound and the smooth bowing that you want. And this is because you might be making the exact right movements, but you're not really making them in sync with the bow. Now what I mean is this. Now you might already know, if you've seen some of my videos about bowing smoothly, that you need to curve your fingers at the frog and your wrist goes a bit up. And if you make a down bow, then you fold out your arm and you stretch your fingers a little bit, and also your wrist goes down, not like this, but your wrist goes a little bit up on the up bow, and you curve your fingers, bend your thumb a bit, and then on the down bow you do this. Now depending on your hand and how it's built and what type of bow hold you're using, you'll see this as a very pronounced movement, or you'll barely see it. For example, there's a difference between the Franco-Belgian bow hold, where you clearly see the finger movement, and the Russian bow hold, where the fingers are slightly straighter, but definitely make use of this spring system, because if your fingers are stiff, it's almost impossible to bow smoothly. Now, if you're already making these nice fluent movements and everything seems to be all right, but your bow is still going everywhere, you don't have the control you want, and you definitely don't have the sound you want, then the problem might just be in that you are forcing these movements. So actually the movement should be related to making this round movement of your wrist actually into the straight movement of your bow. So just like you're throwing a ball, you're doing this. But if I'm doing these movements too little, too much, or too early, or too late, then I might make the right movements, but I still don't get the right bowing and the right sound. Now, to get this feeling of when you need to curve your fingers and how much, etc., then you might want to hold your violin bow at the tip, and then with your hand you go over the bow. So you really feel what this line that the bow usually makes while bowing, how that actually goes. So maybe you should curve your fingers more than you did, or maybe you overdid it and you're curving your fingers too much or too early or too late. So if you do this, then you can really get that feeling and make sure that you're doing this in the same angle as you would normally bow, and then you can transfer that to the violin. Do this exercise. You don't have to do it lots of times. It's just about developing the feeling, and let me know in the comments if you noticed some improvement. Now thank you so much for watching this lesson. I hope to see you in my lesson next week, so please like this video and subscribe to my channel. And, well, until next time. Bye-bye.